Our God is still on his throne and ruling the affairs of man. Even as he does not change, his truths have not changed. Thankfully, God still has a people which proclaim that old-time religion, setting forth his sovereignty, and the old paths of truth where we can find rest for our souls. Welcome to Word of Sovereign Grace, a ministry of Paradise Primitive Baptist Church in Arlington, Texas. Get your Bible, call your friends, and sit back as we open the King James Scriptures to explore the glorious Word of Sovereign Grace. Here's this week's message.
I may not have no one around. I may me out in the woods, as I love to walk from time to time and to dwell upon the beauty of God's creation. But if it comes in that moment of time, I'll not be alone.
Amen.
That's one thing in life that I'll not have to face alone. Because I feel like, as we've got evidence within God's Word, as Stephen's was being stoned, we realize there were others there with Stephen, but not to comfort him. But as they were taking his life, Stephen saw one of the beautifulest visions, if you will, that's ever been recorded. He says, "I see the heavens open, and I see the glory of God standing on the right hand. I see Jesus." That's what I want to do, is to see my Lord. To be able to give Him the praise, the honor, the glory, Brother Otis. As I feel like that we've attempted from time to time, but we've not been able to praise Him like we would love. Just as in your dream, you're not being able to express those things that you saw or that you might have felt. I've not been able to express to the Lord just how much that I do love Him. He expressed His love toward us. Greater love hath no man than He lay down His life for His friends. Those weren't just words that He had pinned down for us, but we read in His Word where He laid His life down that we might have life and live in a hope that some glorious day, as He had the power not only to lay it down, but to take it up again, that some glorious day that we're going to rise in His likeness. Oh, I think so many times of those that we've walked with and of those that have outstripped us and gone on. And I'm one that believes in dreams. Do you believe in dreams? If you don't, we won't fall out. But I believe that God, from time to time, that He shows us things within dreams, and that He can bring peace to our heart and to our souls when we're troubled and tossed about to and fro. I may have shared with you before, and if I have, forgive me for sharing again, but I get a lot of comfort sometimes. We realize, child of grace, those in our lives, those that we love, those that have gone, yet the sweet memories that we have. I remember there my precious father, how that in the latter days of his life, how that he was sickly and afflicted and suffered so. And oh, how that my heart was broken and you felt so helpless that there's something you'd love to do and nothing that you can, not having any power. But oh, what joy and what peace there is to know of the one that has all power in heaven and in earth, and that none can stay His hand. We know not why. We know why death comes. It's because of the sin that is within this body of ours. But I do not know why some may live longer than others do, other than to say the Bible says, when sin is finished, it brings forth death, and leave it right there. That doesn't mean if you live old that you're any more of a sinner than I am. But we realize that after my precious father there had left this world, being troubled in heart, being young, and not understanding my mind, there as I begin to read in God's Word, and going back to David, where his son was somewhat stricken because of the actions of David there. But as David had prayed and fasted and rent his clothes, and he sat in the ashes and the sackcloth, there that when he had gotten news of his son passing away, how that, and this is control. contrary to the nature of man. We got things completely backwards. We need to rejoice there in one's death, a child of grace. And I believe the scripture for that, I don't recall just where, and that it might be to mourn there the devil on the one of the birth of one's birth, but to rejoice in death. And it's somewhat hard for us to be able to do so there in the flesh. But now that I was troubled, missing my precious father and others that have outstripped and gone on, feeling like I had lost all that I had held dear unto. But I had a dream one night, there is my father appeared. Oh, child of grace, what joy, what comfort, what peace there was, what calm is in that head come out. You know, when David had gotten the news thereof, his son living in this world, he cleaned himself up and he went on about his business. That's what we're to do when we lose one. We're to carry on, child of grace. There's nothing more that we can do but to live our life there and live it in Christ. Walk in the way that he helped us and walk. Oh, how they couldn't understand here while the land was living. You were sad, but now you've got news of his death, and yet you're somewhat rejoicing. Oh, let me tell you, when we see loved ones suffer, yes, we can gladly let go, knowing that suffering is over, knowing there's no more affliction, no more care for our loved one. Child of grace, have you ever seen the one suffer so there, and nothing to ease the pain, and nothing whatsoever that you can do? But let me tell you, I believe, and no matter the amount of suffering we might do, it doesn't compare to the suffering of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, as he hung there on the cross of Calvary. Oh, Isaiah said he's a man acquainted with grief and with sorrow. Yes, he knows the infirmities of this own body, and the aches and the pain there. But I seen my father one night as I was laying on my bed, grieving in. Oh, he come there. Brother, oh, as you mentioned the rope and how white it was. The words cannot describe the brightness there in this robe. going to let Brother Melvin come on. I'm Bud. In the book of Thessalonians, I might even go and turn. He says, behold, I'll show you a mystery. Oh, there's some mysteries in God. But he has revealed him thereunto his children. Oh, we shall not all sleep. You know, there are those that believe here that the soul sleepeth, that when death comes, there and that soul is in a dormant state, even though it went back into the heavens. I don't believe that a child in grace will the Bible says that when the Lord comes, he's going to bring those that are asleep with him. Oh, let me just go for a little moment here and see or to show what I see in that. If God would so bless me to you, remember one by the name of Lazarus. Yes, you read clear that he had a sickness, and they sent for the Lord, and the Lord tarried, and didn't he? Yes, he did. Was he too late? No, he's never been too late. I don't believe in a God here that has ever been or will ever be too late. Oh, sometimes I might have an appointment here or there or for this or that. I may barely make it. I might be hindered and I might be late. And the Lord never is hindered. Tom Graves, here, you remember, they sent for the Lord, and they knew he had the power, and if he was there, he could command, and Lazarus be made whole, and that's the God, I believe in, the one with the power, to speak, and it's done, John Graves, I don't believe man has that power. If I had it, I wouldn't be here, I'd be without a job, and we not need the hospital here. And Jesus heard, and when he came there, they said to him, Lord, if thou had only been here, my brother Lazarus would have still lived. Yes, oh, let me tell you, God was about to show the power that he does possess. You know, sometimes here, was it John? And he said, go show John again these things. We need reminded from time to time here in life. But he said, do you believe in Brother Lazarus living in? Yes. He said, he'll live in the morning of the resurrection. Oh, the Lord said, I am in the resurrection. I am the life of all men. Here he said, and this sickness is not unto death, but that I might show my power and my glory. Here your brother Lazarus is not dead, he sleepeth. Oh Lord, if he sleepeth, he too is fine. Let me tell you, every one of God's children, when death comes, they fall asleep. They're in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Where else would you want to be? Oh, and the Bible says, when death comes, and the body goes back to the earth, and that which is born of God goes back yonder to heaven. You'll never find anywhere in the Bible where it speaks of the soul of man being asleep. John Graves, and the Lord said, he sleepeth. They said, if he sleepeth, he doeth fine. And the Lord said, he's dead. He's dead. There's no more life in that body. That body is going to sleep there. It'll go back to the earth from whence it cometh. But that spirit there, he's planted within our hearts and souls. It's alive, child of grace. It was alive when he planted it there. And it's always alive. He says, if thou knowest the gift of God there, what is the gift of God? It's eternal life. Something there that'll never sleep, never falter, and never be taken away. You can't lose it. Are we waiting for it? We've got it now. And Christ has come and taken it. body goes back to the earth, and the spirit goes back to heaven from whence it comes. And that spirit is Christ Jesus. Yes, it is. And the spirit that we're born of is Christ Himself, as He's taken her abode here. I'm leaving her shout in heaven. Helping one of her little ones leave this world. And Brother Ken, I believe the dear sister, when she left last night, not only was her shout in heaven, and when I leave her spirit, shouted as it left this world there, and that it might glorify God. And rest assured of this, it's going to shout when He comes back. Yes, it is. But we go to sleep in this body, and the Lord teaches death is nothing more than a night of rest. That's like laying down and going to bed for a night. Wait till and the Lord comes again. He'll bring those that are asleep, who are asleep. It's the bodies of those that He has redeemed, the time and grace, and not the spirit, but the body is asleep. I'll bring them that are asleep and reunite it with that body. When the Lord comes again, oh, He's coming. Yeah. Oh, some says, what a sad day that's going to be. Oh, that's going to be a glorious day. Oh, yes, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus and His righteousness. Oh, I'd love to be standing somewhere singing the praise of my God when He comes back. But I know this, it might be 1,000 years from now. It might be tomorrow. It might be the next moment. We don't know. But I believe whether I'll be living or whether I'm dead and gone back to the earth, that when He comes and that spirit reunites with the body, I'm going to come out of the grave shouting praises to the Lord. And the Lord's head, He'll come with a shout, the voice of the archangel and the trump of God. And those that are dead and in the grave shall come forth to the grave. Yes, and we that are alive and remain, so we'll be changed in the morning, in the twinkling of an eye, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Oh, we may lose loved ones, our families may dwindle, church membership may dwindle. How many have you seen there on the outside that needs to be on the inside? And let me tell you, child of grace, when the Lord comes again, there not be none looking on the outside. And no, He'll gather His children there. He said He'd even sift the sand from the sea. He'll say there to the north come and to the south not hold back there. And there'll be nothing to prevent Him from coming forth. All and the Father giveth, He said, shall come unto me. Oh, we know all don't come in this life. And no, when I mean they're born of His Spirit, whether they walk in obedience or disobedience, the Lord has made known you're a heaven bought and you're a heaven bound. And yes, and child of grace, but in that day, there'll not be the loss of one. Oh, there's going to be a gathering. We speak up. We love to see the house full. Every seat taken. Chairs put out. Oh, you won't have to worry about chairs or seats. We won't need them. We'll be praising our Lord. Here, I want to turn and just one more place and give away. And John 14 says this, in my Father's house are many mansions. I want to touch just a little bit on that. And there's something more greater than what I'm going to tell you there in correlation with the tabernacle here. But I want you to understand, God is not building rooms there in heaven today. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so,
Anchored
Sovereign Grace, a ministry of Paradise Primitive Baptist Church in Arlington, Texas. Paradise Primitive Baptist Church is located at 5300 Mansfield Road in Arlington, Texas. Services begin at 10:30 each Sunday morning. Plan to come and worship with us. To find out more about Paradise Primitive Baptist Church, visit www.paradisepbc.org. Be sure to visit our website for articles, video, and audio sermons, as well as biblical answers to your questions. Thanks for watching, and be sure to join us again next week. May God richly bless you.